Theme two, peace and politics, women negotiating power with men. Wajir women waging peace. It was like this. The venom of violence had stung our fathers, husbands, sons. Their Kalashnikovs became dearer to them than us, their wives, or their own lives. We lived in torment, our nights and days punctuated by gunshots, the crisp, dry air of our village shredded with war cries and lamentations for lost ones. One day, we had enough. We met in secret, pondering long what we should do, till Rahima, the oldest of our ladies, declared, "We are ready, the time has come." She summoned the Shura Council of Elders. Never before had a woman sat in the circle of the Shura. Never had a woman addressed the men in public, face to face. We went there, as one, all the women of our village. They were all there. The men, the elders, the boys, playing with their guns like toys, scowling at our intrusion. When the clan's leader raised his arm for Rahima to speak, she spoke through her veil. "Respected leaders, menfolk, for centuries we women have obeyed your will. But today, our minds and hearts permit us no longer to follow you in your deadly folly. We can no longer sit still when our past and future are in flames. Today, you will listen to us. This is our non-negotiable demand. First, our village is now declared a zone of peace. You will leave your guns outside the village. No man may bring his gun into the marketplace or into his own home. Just as we shed our slippers when we enter the mosque, you will drop your guns outside the village in a sequestered spot. Second, we ask that you meet and negotiate with the members of the other clans. We will arrange the meeting. We just ask that you come not bent on vengeance, but dreaming of our children's future and the legacy we leave them. Third, we ask that you accept us, your women, as members of the Shura Council. We repudiate our clan allegiances. We constitute ourselves as the sixth clan, the clan of women. Our only allegiance is to defend the interests of our community and our people and our land. And if you don't agree, there will be consequences. We shall go on strike, all the women, each one of us, in the kitchens, in the fields, in the markets, and in bed. An astonished silence followed. Then the rattling of guns and noises. One man shouted, "How dare they?" Another, "Let us teach these witches a lesson." The Shura leader lifted his hand in a fist, then placed it on his heart. Rahima, you have shamed us into remembering our code of honor. Your truth, we cannot and will not deny. From today, you are a member of the Shura Council. We accept you as the sixth clan. You are the keeper of our traditions. Without you, our women, we are but unconceived dust. From that day on, we began to work together, men and women to bring peace to our ancient desert land. This piece is devoted to Deka Ibrahim Abdi from the Wajir region in Kenya, who created the Wajir Peace and Development Community, and to Asha Heji Elmi, who founded the Sixth Clan in Somalia and brought women first to the negotiating table and then into government. It is also dedicated to the 1,000 women who richly deserve the Peace Prize and have not yet won it. Despite the risks and dangers, women everywhere, in Afghanistan, in Iraq, across the Middle East, in all parts of the world, are stepping forward to reshape politics, to renegotiate power with men.